Hey family, I hope you guys are doing well. Thank you so much for tuning in. My name is Millie, for those of you who are new to the channel. Thank you for subscribing. Welcome to my new subscribers. I appreciate all of you guys, your likes, your shares, comments, your emails. Those of you who have sown seeds, thank you so much. I appreciate you all. It's just amazing what God is doing in my life, this new thing that He is doing. Which is what I'm going to talk about today, the new era that we're in, okay? I spent some time with the Lord today, and I just really was looking for my next steps and the blueprint of my life. And I hope you guys are doing that as well, that you're seeking God's face for your next steps and the blueprint for your life. And so in doing that, He shared quite a few things with me, but He reconfirmed new era, which is something He has been highlighting to me for the past week, maybe almost 2 weeks now. And what He means by that is that we're in a new time. Things are no longer going to be the way they used to be. He's moving the church into a time where He is training us up to operate in the authority and power that He destined for us to operate in before the fall of man, okay? He wants us at our highest actualization, at our highest potential, okay? And some of us He's taken through the fire and has refined us already so that we can come into that, right? And so He is doing something big, as He's had me speak on this before. He's doing something big. He's doing something new in this nation and in the lives individually of His children, okay? And we are all familiar with the new thing scripture in Isaiah chapter 43. It's verses 18 through 19, where it says, "Forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. See, I'm doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland." So we are familiar with that, right? But what He showed me in Isaiah chapter 48, which I have the camera on right now, and please forgive my Bible, you guys. It's like almost 30 years old, so it has been put to use. But what He was highlighting to me in chapter 48 of Isaiah is that He is doing things, and I've mentioned this in previous videos, that He's doing new things that have not been seen on the earth before in this season, okay? And some of you, He's already spoken to you about this new thing. He's already told you He's going to make your name great. You almost have had, not even almost, some of you have had like an Abraham experience, like He told you to get up, get out of your father's house, you know, move to the land I will show you, and you've done that. And now you're waiting, you're in the promised land, you're taking the land, and you're about to get your blueprint, okay? And so in Isaiah 48, He is dealing with the obstinate nation of Israel. Obstinate meaning refusing to change, or the rebellion of the people opposing or resisting the change. And He doesn't want us to miss this new thing that He's doing, right? So in this chapter, He points out the hard-headedness of His people, which today we're definitely hard-headed. A lot of us still aren't listening to the Lord, okay? We're not listening. We're not obeying. We're not doing what it is that He's asking us to do. And then even in some of our lives where He has shown up and shown out, we don't give Him the glory. You know, we say our own hands have done it. We say that, you know, it's by my own strength, or, you know, whatever we want to say, we're not giving God His full glory, okay? So I'm just going to read a few verses out of Isaiah chapter 48 that He highlighted to me, and then tell you guys a few other things that He showed me. So I'm going to read verses 3, 6, 8, 10, and 11. So verse 3 says, "The former things I declared long ago, they went out from my mouth and I made them known. Then suddenly I did them and they came to pass." Verse 6, "You have heard, now see all this, and will you not declare it?" That means, are you not going to give me the glory for what I've already done in your life? He says, "From this time forward, I make you hear new things, hidden things that you have not known." Verse 8, "You have never heard, you have never known from of old, your ear has not been open, for I knew that you would deal very treacherously and that from birth you were called a rebel. Verses 10 through 11 read, "See, I have refined you, but not like silver. I have tested you in the furnace of adversity. For my sake, for my own sake, I do it. For why should my name be profaned? My glory I will not give to another." So what the Lord is saying here is that I've always told you, I've always revealed to you the things that I'm going to do. And I tell you what I'm going to do beforehand. And that's what prophecy is, you guys, is knowing what God's is going to do before it comes to pass. It's his word. And this is what Isaiah 55:11 speaks of when the scripture says his word goes forth, you know, and it will not return unto him void. It won't accomplish, or it will, excuse me, accomplish that which he sent it to do. So he always sends the word, and he wants each and every one of you to know that this blueprint that you keep hearing about, some of you have heard this through other people of God that are being used right now, the remnant, different, however, they're operating in the fivefold ministry. Some of you may have heard this blueprint phrase, right? And so God is saying that seek my face, sit at my feet so you can get the instruction. Okay. He wants to spend the time with you. Just like I did this morning, he gave me some instructions, you guys, like this channel is going to take another direction, more teaching, some deep things, like some people are about to be freed through this channel, which is the main goal of the Kingdom of God Matters, is to get you guys on the kingdom mindset, the way that God does things, the way that he operates in his government and out of the world's way, right? And so what he's saying is that I've sent the word forth, I've done these things, and yet my people, they still rebelled against me. They still didn't give me the honor and glory, or they forgot me, or, you know, they didn't, you know, praise me, or what have you, okay? And so he's saying now, Since you don't, you act like you don't really know who did this for you, or what your saving grace is, or how you came to this place, you know, of prosperity or wherever you are. This is why he took you through the furnace of affliction or the furnace of adversity. Some of you ran into difficult times where it's almost, again, the Ishmael and Isaac situation where we were doing things. God was still blessing it. He still blessed Ishmael, but it wasn't in alignment with what he wanted for us. It wasn't the promise. It wasn't Isaac, right? So this is why a lot of you are having that Abraham experience where he has pretty much stripped you of those things and said, okay, let that go. You got to put that aside. I got to get you in alignment, okay, so that you can walk into the promise, into the thing that I have for you, okay? So this is the new era. This is the new thing. This is the new thing. So for some of you, he mentions in verse 8, you have never heard, you have never known. From of old, your ear has not been open. See, he could not tell you these things until he grew you to a place in the furnace of affliction or adversity that caused you to go deeper with him and to know him more. Okay. And to get closer to him and to let go of your idols, your people idols, you know, those relationships, your career. Some of you all have been called out of careers and your whole life has changed. He's putting you to a whole nother thing. He's raising some of you up in ministry. You had no idea, you know, and I'm speaking to myself with this as well. Okay. And so what he's saying is now, this time forward, I make you hear new things, hidden things, so that I may get the glory, okay? So you guys, it's a new era, it's a new time. He's training us up, he's doing things differently. He's actually giving the blueprints, as I mentioned, to a lot of you, okay? You're in a position to receive your instructions, and do not seek out your instructions from anyone else. God is the only one who has the specific detail. Yes, he'll send you confirmations and things like that. But some of you are like in a position where you're kind of stuck. You don't know which way to go now. It's like you've done the last thing God told you to do. And you need to know, okay, what next? So go to him. He'll tell you either continue on, or he'll give you what your new thing is, what the next step is. Okay? I love you all. And most importantly, Jesus loves you. I just want to pray for us really quickly. Father God, I thank you for this message. I ask that it transform the lives of your people. I thank you for the big and lofty things that you have promised to us. I ask that you open up the minds of your people so that they can expand their capacity, Lord God, to broaden their vision, Lord God, to see what it is that you have for them to do, Father God. Thank you for loving us so much. Thank you for your mercy and your grace, Lord God. Thank you for the new era, the new time we're in, that you're doing a new thing, Lord God, that we may perceive the new thing, Father God. It's all for your kingdom. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Father God, I just ask that you continue to free your people, free your people. And again, I thank you for this new thing, for it will bring you all the glory. Everything that you are doing is going to bring you all the glory. We can't say I did it. We can't say she did it, he did it, they did it. It's going to be you, God. All you. All glory goes to you, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, I plead the blood of Jesus over everyone under the sound of my voice. Protect them, Lord. Keep them, Lord. Hedge them in before and behind, Lord God. Keep your angels all around in the mighty name of Jesus, warring for them, protecting them, Lord God, and everyone that is connected to them, Father God. Thank you, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. You guys be blessed, and I'll talk to you soon.